Do you love the sound of rain pattering on your roof during a summer rainstorm? Or watching big, beautiful snowflakes as they slowly twirl to the ground? Weather is a wonder, and it's usually mild and enjoyable. However, occasionally the weather can be severe, causing damage to homes, property, and natural habitats. Let's take a look at two such types of extreme weather: tornadoes and tropical cyclones. Thunderstorms can be fun to watch safely from inside, but some thunderstorms are powerful with extremely high winds. As these high, fast wind currents collide with low and slow wind currents, the air in between begins to spin rapidly, creating a rotating thunderstorm. This is called a supercell. This column of spinning air creates a funnel, and water vapor within the funnel begins to condense into tiny water droplets, making the funnel visible. In the center of the rotating funnel is an air mass called a mesocyclone, and sometimes this mesocyclone pushes downward through the bottom of the storm clouds. If it continues, it will reach the ground. And when this rotating funnel touches the ground, it becomes a tornado. Although we know a lot about this weather phenomenon, scientists do not yet know why some supercells form tornadoes and others do not. The size of a tornado and the destruction it can cause are ranked on a scale called the Enhanced Fujita scale. Tornadoes are ranked between an EF0 and an EF5. Tornadoes ranked at EF3 to EF5 can do major damage to homes, trees, and even entire communities. Thankfully, meteorologists continue to improve forecasting models and early tornado warning systems, which provide more time for people to get to safety. Tropical cyclones are another type of extreme weather. These are sometimes called hurricanes or typhoons, depending on where you live. When the ocean water is very warm, the surrounding air begins to warm too. And as you've learned before, warm air rises. As it does, cool air rushes in to take its place. All that warm air contains large amounts of water vapor, which condenses into clouds as it rises and cools. As this cycle is repeated over and over, massive storm clouds are formed. Some of the rising air is pushed inward towards the center of the storm, which can grow to span over 10 miles high and 1,000 miles across. Because the Earth spins on its axis, these very large storm clouds also spin. Interestingly, the direction of circulation differs in the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere. Tropical cyclones in the Northern Hemisphere spin counterclockwise, and in the Southern Hemisphere, they spin clockwise. A tropical cyclone is made up of three main parts: the eye wall, and the rain bands. The eye is at the center of the tropical cyclone, and it can be seen from outer space. This area is calm, with only light winds and clear skies. It can be as small as 2 miles wide or as large as 200 miles wide. The eye wall, which surrounds the eye of the tropical cyclone, is the most powerful part of the storm, with tall clouds, strong winds, and heavy rainfall. The rain bands are storm-filled bands of cloud that spiral outward away from the eye. The rain bands are what give tropical cyclones their corkscrew appearance. Similar to tornadoes and other natural disasters, tropical cyclones have different strengths and sizes and are given a ranking between Category 1 and Category 5 according to wind speeds. Meteorologists have a good understanding of how tropical cyclones form and behave, and scientists monitor their formation and paths using tools on the ground, in the air, and in space. Unlike tornadoes, which form quickly and follow unpredictable paths, tropical cyclones can be tracked days before they make landfall, and meteorologists can usually accurately predict where the storm will strike. Many early warning systems have been established and countless lives saved thanks to the efforts of scientists and researchers worldwide. Extreme weather can be awe-inspiring to study, though difficult to witness, and is a part of God's amazing creation.